In this video, we're going to begin the KutaSoftware Infinite Geometry free worksheet, the Pythagorean Theorem, and its converse. Quickly, I'll go over the Pythagorean Theorem. If you have a right triangle, the Pythagorean Theorem is a squared plus b squared equals c squared. A and b are the lengths of the leg, so this leg can be a and this leg b, or vice versa. This leg can be b and this leg can be a. However, the hypotenuse is always C, and the hypotenuse is the side directly across from that right angle. So the length of one leg squared plus the length of another leg squared will equal the length of the hypotenuse squared. Now, our directions are to find the missing side of each triangle and to round our answer to the nearest tenth if necessary. And number one, our missing side is a leg, so this leg can be A, or this leg can be B. Let's just make 12 inches A, the other leg B, and then C is directly across from the right angle, so this is C. A squared plus B squared equals C squared. So the length A squared will have 12 inches squared plus the length B squared, which is given to us as X squared, is going to equal 13 inches squared. So 13 squared. Now we're going to simplify and solve for x. 12 squared is 144, and we're still adding that to x squared, and that's equal to 13 squared, which is 169. Now I want to isolate this term with the x, so I'll subtract 144 from both sides. In doing this, I'll get that x squared is equal to 25. And now I can take the square root of both sides to solve for x. So the square root of x squared is x, and the square root of 25 is 5. So in number 1, x is equal to 5. That missing length is 5, and that's going to be inches. So 5 inches, since our units are inches. In number 2, we have one leg A, another leg B, and the hypotenuse is our missing side, C. So a squared plus b squared equals c squared. And note, a and b are both in terms of miles, so c will also be miles. A squared, 3 squared, plus b squared, which is 4 squared, and that's going to equal c squared, which is x squared. 3 squared is 9, plus 4 squared is 16, and that's equal to x squared. 9 plus 16 is 25, so 25 equals x squared. And when we take the square root of both sides, we get that 5 is equal to x. And remember, we're talking in terms of miles, so 5 miles is our solution in number 2. That hypotenuse is 5 miles. And you can see that it is a 3, 4, 5 triangle. In number 3, we're given our hypotenuse C, and we're given one leg. Let's call this leg B. So the other leg, X, or A, is missing. So for A squared plus B squared equals C squared, we'll have A squared, which is X squared, plus 11.9 squared, equal to C squared, which is 14.7 squared. And note that we're using the label kilometers, so A will also be in kilometers. So we'll have x squared plus 11.9 squared is 141.61. So I'll round that to 6. And that's equal to 14.7 squared, which is 216.09, which rounds to 0.1. Now I'll subtract 141.6 from both sides. That'll help me isolate my term with my x. So x squared will be all by itself on the left-hand side of my equation, and that will be equal to 74.5, so 74 and 5 tenths. Now, I'll take the square root of both sides. Square root of x squared is x, and the square root of 74.5 is 8.63, which rounds to 8.6, because remember, we're rounding to the nearest tenth, and the label is kilometers. So x is equal to 8.6 kilometers in number 3. And number 4, we're given our hypotenuse, C, we're given a side, A, and we need to find another side, B. So we'll have A squared plus B squared equal to C squared. A squared is 6.3, that's squared, plus B squared, which is X squared, and that's equal to C squared, which is 15.4 squared. 6.3 squared is approximately 39.7. And we're adding that to x squared, and that will give us our hypotenuse squared, which is 15.4 squared, which equals 237.2. Now subtracting 39.7 from both sides, I'll get that x squared is equal to 197.5. Taking the square root of both sides, I'll get x all by itself, and that's equal to the square root of 197.5, which is 14.05, which rounds to 14.1, and this is in miles. So 14.1 miles is our missing side in number 4. In number 5 and 6, we're still finding the missing side of each triangle, however, this time we're leaving our answer in simplest radical form. So in number 5, we're given our C, and we're given an A, or a B, and we need to find our other A or B term. So let's make A the side with X, B the side with 13, and C is 15 yards. So I'll have X squared plus 13 squared equal to C squared, which is 15 squared, and this is in yards. So x squared plus 13 squared is 169. That's going to equal 15 squared, which is 225. Now my next step is to subtract 169 from both sides. I'll get that x squared is equal to 56. Now taking the square root of both sides, I'll get that x is equal to the square root of 56. However, the square root of 56 is not a perfect square, so we're going to see what perfect square multiplies to give us 56 so that we can pull it out. So 56 is divisible by 4. 4 times 14 will give us 56, and 4 is a perfect square. So we'll have that x is equal to the square root of 4 times the square root of 14. So x is equal to the square root of 4, which is 2 times the square root of 14, and we need to put back in our label, which is yards. So 2 times the square root of 14 yards is our solution in number 5. In number 6, we have a C, we have an A, and we're missing a B. So 8 squared plus x squared equals C squared, which is 16 squared. 8 squared is 64 plus x squared is going to be equal to our hypotenuse squared, which is 16 squared, which equals 256. Subtracting 64 from both sides, I'll get that x squared, the length of one of our legs in our right triangle, squared, is equal to 192. Now, when I take the square root of both sides, I'll get that x is equal to the square root of 192. So what perfect square fits into 192? 192 we can write as the square root of 64 times 3, since 64 times 3 equals 192. So we can split up that radical as the square root of 64 times the square root of 3. And since 64 is a perfect square, we can say x equals 8 times the square root of 3, and our label is kilometers. So 8 times the square root of 3 kilometers is our solution in number 6. And lastly in this video, I'll go over number 7 and 8. Our directions for 7 and 8 are to find the missing side of each right triangle. Side C is the hypotenuse, and sides A and B are the legs. So we're to leave our answer in simplest radical form. So as opposed to giving us a picture, they're telling us what A, B, and or C are equivalent to. So before I go over the solution to these, please remember to click that subscribe button and like this video. In number 7, they give us A and C. Remember, a squared plus b squared equals our hypotenuse squared, c squared. So a squared is 11 squared plus b squared is what we're missing, and that's equal to c squared, which is 15 squared. 11 squared is 121 plus b squared is equal to 15 squared, which is 225. Subtracting 121 from both sides, we'll get that b squared is equal to 104. So now we're going to take the square root of both sides to see what b is equivalent to. So that side b is equal to the square root of 104. But I'm going to split the square root of 104 up. We need to figure out what perfect square goes into 104. 104 is divisible by 4. 4 times 26 is equivalent to 104. So I can split b up as the square root of 4 times the square root of 26. So b will equal 2 times the square root of 26, and our label is meters, m. So 2 times the square root of 26 meters. And number 8, we're not given a. But remember, a squared plus b squared equals c squared. A squared plus the square root of 6 squared equal to 4 squared. So that's a squared plus the square root of 6 squared is 6, and that's equal to 4 squared, which is 16. Subtracting 6 from both sides, I'll get that a squared, the length of my side, squared, is equal to 10. And when I take the square root of that, I'll get the length of the side. So a is equal to the square root of 10. And there's not a perfect square that can go into the square root of 10, so that's our simplest radical form. A equals the square root of 10, and that's the square root of 10 yards. And that wraps up this video. Join me in the next video where I'll complete the second page of this worksheet. If you have any questions, leave a comment below, and don't forget to like, subscribe, and share.